Wow, it looks beautiful.
It was adventurous.
Millions of years ago.
And the Gobi, water is precious.
Horse racing.
Oh, it's excellent.
And the Gobi.
A beautiful sunset.
If you can see this cliff,
in previous episodes of Explore Mongolia, we showed you some of the must-see places and tourist destinations in northern Mongolia. This time, we're heading off to travel to southern Mongolia, the Great Gobi. What is the Gobi? You might imagine the Gobi as a lifeless desert, the vast steppe, dunes, hot weather, and harsh conditions. But behind these images of the Gobi, there are incredible wonders such as the unique natural formations, archaeological sites, some of the rarest animals on Earth, and the nomadic lifestyle of the local people. Before leaving Ubi, we stopped at the supermarket to buy some food supplies. Water must be the first on your list of essentials when you travel to the Gobi. Choose what you need and choose what you like. Everything is a choice in a supermarket and in life. Put your favorites in your basket. Choose happiness in your life.
Now we are leaving Ubi, the bustling city with 380 years of history.
Our first destination is Ikazrincholo. It is about 300 kilometers from Ubi, and it's a 5-hour drive to get there.
Hey, look at these animals. On the way of our journey, we came across these camels. Mongolian Gobi is the home of two-humped camels. How many of them are here? I guess 60, maybe 70 or something.
As you know, there are two types of camels, the one-humped dromedary and the two-humped Bactrian camel. Bactrian camels make up about 10% of all the camels on Earth. There are over 470,000 Bactrian camels now in Mongolia. As we're approaching Ikazrincholo, it started to rain. It was great because it had not rained in the area for a month. This is what the rock formations look like in the rain from 10 kilometers away. After driving for about 5 hours, we arrived at our first destination, Ikazrincholo. Munk Ocher, a local ranger, welcomed us. We asked him to guide us through the rock formations. He was kind enough to show us the beauty of this breathtaking landscape. My first impression of these rock formations was a feeling of awe. They were magnificent. It was unbelievable to see such interesting rock formations in the Gobi. What a wonder of nature.
The great rock mountains in the Gobi area.
From east to west, it covers more than 20 kilometers. The highest peak of the rock formation is 1700 meters. Ikazrincholo became a protected area in 2003 due to its unique landscape.
I'm scrambling down the cliff. Wonderful natural formation. It's one of the best tourist destinations in Mongolia, especially in the Mongolian Gobi Desert.
Here is an open-air theater in this unusual natural landscape.
It was founded in 2006 on the occasion of the 800th anniversary of the establishment of the Great Mongolian Empire. Several international and domestic art festivals have been organized at this theater.
Last year, in 2019, over 3,000 folk dancers, singers, and musicians performed here. Wow, it looks beautiful. The beautiful monument dedicated to the Mongolian state-honored long song singer Nor Banzab stands here. She was born and grew up in this area.
Mongolians say that Nor Banzab was the queen of long song. Oihang Zambativi Narang, or The Gentle Son of the World, is one of her best songs. The lyrics of the song are written on the wall of the monument.
There are more than 40 caves around here. The caves are not difficult to access and close to each other. It seems ideal for hiking.
There are many caves in these rock formations. This one is known for being used as a location for a classic film. Altun Urgo is one of the most popular classic movies in Mongolia. It was filmed in 1961 and was a co-production with East Germany. Tourists must be interested in the natural formations here. How many travelers do you receive each year? About 1,500 foreign and domestic travelers come here every year to see this wonderful landscape. They also want to see wild animals such as the ibex and wild mountain sheep. What about the activities travelers can do here, such as horse trekking and hiking? These rock formations are suitable for hiking and climbing. Of course, you can ride horses and camels. A visit to the home of a nomadic family is also available. If you are interested in a specific species of rare plants and animals, there is plenty to do and see. Can you tell us about the interesting formation of this place? Paleontologists believe that this place was once the floor of an ocean. As you can see, all the granite formations were formed vertically. This is what makes this place beautiful and magnificent. Some rock formations have very interesting shapes. How long have you been working as a ranger, and what are your duties? I've been working as a ranger here since 2008. My duties include reminding travelers to follow the rules and regulations of the protected areas and providing them with guidance on safe and responsible travel. It is important to preserve nature and protect wildlife. After exploring this stunning natural landscape, what do travelers tell you? They usually say, "Wow, it looks like a rock forest." There is a tourist camp at this beautiful place. Unfortunately, the camp is closed this year because of the COVID-19 pandemic, so we had to go to our next destination without the chance to stay. Our next destination is Tsagaan Sovruk, or White Stupa. It's about 250 kilometers from our first destination, Ikhkazrincholo. What is Tsagaan Sovruk? It is a beautiful scarp, a line of cliffs in the Gobi Desert. When we arrived at Tsagaan Sovruk, it was quite windy. Despite the wind, travelers were enjoying views of the landscape. There have been no foreign arrivals but domestic travelers are exploring Mongolia. We interviewed Badr Sureng, who was traveling with his family. How is your trip? Pretty good. My wife and I are traveling with our children and grandchildren. They are quite happy with the tour. Our children admire the beauty of the Gobi. What would you say about this landscape, Tsagan Zorok? I would say it's a masterpiece of nature. Who else could create such a beautiful formation but nature? It's really amazing. You can't find this kind of masterpiece anywhere else in the world. Can you tell us more about the character of the Gobi? The Gobi is a challenging place to live. Its inhabitants have strong survival skills. For example, plants in the Gobi are sparse. They are not thick, but they can survive for months when there is no rain. As for the animals, they are the same. They have adapted to the harsh conditions over thousands of years. People in the Gobi region are more tolerant and hardworking than people living in other parts of the country. At first glance, the Gobi is tough. If you look carefully and find the secrets of the Gobi, it's full of wonders. Thank you and have a good trip. My pleasure. Good luck to all of you. In recent years, Mongolians have enjoyed more traveling in Mongolia and seeing the beauty of the country rather than traveling abroad. Due to the pandemic and foreign travel restrictions, the number of domestic travelers heading to the Gobi has increased this year. We arrived at the Tsagan Zorok tourist camp to stay for a night. It's 5 kilometers from the beautiful cliffs. Seeing the stunning sunset in the Gobi was an unforgettable moment. After sunset, we headed to a cave near the camp. It is about 70 meters long and is known as the Lie and Stand Cave. Some parts of the cave are very shallow. You can only crawl, but other areas are large enough for you to be able to stand up straight. That's how it got its unusual name. Hey, are you ready to start an underground journey with me? Walking through about 70 meter long cave is one of the Gobi Desert adventures. Okay, let's do it. You have to even crawl in some parts of the cave.
Hey, look at this. I found banknotes, Mongolian turkeys. It's interesting. Yes, I did it.
The sunrise in the Gobi was peaceful, although it was windy the day before. This morning gave me a feeling of calm. We want to see the beauty of this scarp again in the sunrise.
Right now, I'm standing at the place which was the bottom of the ocean millions of years ago. This is another breathtaking natural formation in the Mongolian Gobi Desert.
This impressive scarp is about 60 meters at its highest point and is 400 meters long. The face of the scarp is very deep, almost 90 degrees.
You see, the scarp consists of many beautiful colors and layers. It looks so amazing.
Explore Mongolia. Explore Gobi Desert. And the most interesting fact about the Mongolian Gobi is the discoveries of dinosaurs, fossils. Gobi Desert was home to dinosaurs millions of years ago. Whew. Wow. Amazing. Yeah? So beautiful. Breathtaking. Whew. It's a place that's full of natural landscapes, unique landscapes, rare animals, very hospitable people, and many wonders. It's amazing. It looks beautiful.
At the top of the cliffs, we met some other travelers enjoying the morning view of the landscape.
Are you traveling with your family?
I'm traveling with my family, and we're from Ulaanbaatar.
Is it your first time here?
Yes, it's our first time visiting Tsahan Sobrang, and we're all impressed by this natural wonder. After climbing the cliffs, we went back to the camp and enjoyed our breakfast. This guy was born and raised in the Gobi. He has been working as a guide since childhood.
Some people like to walk the way.
Let me introduce this guy. Baza is our guide here, and he's also the grandson of the founder of the tourist camp we stayed last night near the Wadi Stupa or Tsahan Sobrang. You must be proud of your grandmother. I heard she truly wanted to show this place to the world.
Yeah.
So she established the first tourist camp here. She loved Gobi. She also worked for a local museum for many years.
25 years.
Yeah. Tell us about your grandmother.
She was a very ambitious woman. When she used to work at the museum, she always wanted to have a tourist camp of her own. Mm-hmm. But where? Where? And she thought, when you go from Dongda province to Omdo province, you have to stay a night. Mm-hmm. And people didn't have any place to stay at night, so they just camped near the road. But my grandma thought, if you can show this Tsahan Sobrang to the world.
How about your tourist camp? What kind of services do you offer travelers, foreign tourists?
It's this camp is like a family business run by, started by my grandma, but I see it as a treasure passed on from family to family. Lots of customers come here at the evening, have dinner, sleep, see the stupa, and leave in the morning. So. Our most priority is to have great tasting dinner and breakfast.
How long have you been working as guide? As a guide?
Since I was 14, so it's 9 years.
9 years.
Yeah.
Wow.
We wanted Baza to join our tour and show us the beautiful place around the Gobi. Fortunately, he said yes. He's always happy to help people explore the Gobi.
Mongolian gear. This is not only nomadic house, but also an essential part of nomadic culture, way of life, and history. I want to say it's a unique creation designed, used, and developed by Mongolian, nomadic Mongolians over thousands of years. We are leaving the tourist camp now to our next destination, and thank you and goodbye, Tsahan Sobrang.
In the next episode of Explore Mongolia, we'll show you rock drawings at Dil Mountain, the beautiful formation of Yolingam, and ice in the Gobi.
Wow, it looks beautiful.
It was adventurous.
Millions of years ago.
And the Gobi, water is precious.
Horse racing.
Oh, it's excellent.
And the Gobi,
a beautiful sunset.
If you can see this cliff.